In earlier classes, we have discussed about various characteristics of Schottky diode and PN diode. And in this lecture, we see the important differences between a Schottky diode and a PN diode. Although we know that the ideal current voltage characteristics of a Schottky diode and a PN diode looks like similar, but there are still some major differences between these two. So there are two important differences between a Schottky diode and a PN diode. So first difference is the first difference is in the magnitude of the reverse saturation current densities. Magnitude of the reverse saturation current densities and the second major difference is in the switching speed or characteristics. So let's first discuss about why there is a major difference between the magnitude of the reverse saturation current in PN diode and Schottky diode. So first let's discuss this about reverse saturation current. Current densities. It's very important to understand the characteristic of any diode. If we can understand this reverse saturation current, then we can understand its actual use in the circuit. So we know that the reverse saturation current density of a Schottky diode is given by the relation, that's JS. Let me write it short, JS simply, which is equal to A star T square exponential minus EOQ phi B by KT. And we know that A, the reception constant, T is temperature, and phi B, we know that is the Schottky barrier height. So this is the equation for the reverse saturation current of a Schottky diode. Now let's write the reverse saturation current density of a PN diode is JS. I'm writing here PN, which is equal to E DN NP naught by LN plus E DP PN naught by LP. And we know that what is the meaning of LN and LP, because we have already discussed about these terms. And here NP naught is the concentration of electron in the P side, and here PN naught is the concentration of the holes in the N side. That is, these two terms are belonging to the minority carriers in a PN diode. So this is the current density for a PN diode. We can see that above two equations, are very different. In equation first, let me give it a number 1, and this is second one. So in first, we can see that the saturation current depends on the barrier height, and barrier height again depends upon the doping of the semiconductor. But in second equation, we can see that the saturation current depends upon the diffusion of the minority carriers. So it's very important, the mechanism of the reverse saturation current in both of these diodes are very different. So we can think that the magnitude of the reverse saturation current is also different between these diodes. So above two equations are very different, therefore the current mechanism in the two devices is also very different. The current in a PN diode is determined by the diffusion of minority carriers, while the current in a Schottky diode is determined by thermionic emission of the majority carriers over a potential barrier. And in PN diode, we saw that in reverse saturation current, there is a major contribution by the generation current. And typically, the generation current is higher in the PN diode. There is a small generation current in Schottky diode. But still, the generation current in PN diode is higher than the Schottky diode. So, in a one line, we can write a generation current in the reverse biased Schottky diode also exists like in a PN diode. However, the amount of generation current in Schottky diode is negligible . So this is about generation current. So generally we can see that the reverse saturation current density of a Schottky diode is 2 to 3 orders of magnitude higher than the reverse saturation current density of a PN diode. Here we can see that although the generation current is higher in PN diode, but still we can see the amount of reverse saturation current density in Schottky diode is higher than the PN diode. So this is the first major difference between these two. And since reverse saturation current density of Schottky diode is higher than the current density of PN diode, the forward bias characteristics of the two types of diodes are also different. And if we draw IV characteristic of these two devices, in forward bias condition, then if this is the current in milliampere here, and here voltage in volts. Let's say this is for IV relationship for PN diode. And let's say this is the IV relationship for a Schottky diode. So this is for Schottky diode. Normally this is happening about 0.6 or 0.7 voltage for silicon, and for Schottky diode, let me write here scale so that we can differentiate these two. This is about 0.6 and here about 0.4. Here we can see that the effective turn on voltage of the Schottky diode is less than the is less than that of the PN diode. And this difference between the turn on voltage is due to the difference between the barrier height of metal semiconductor junction and the doping in a PN junction and in a Schottky diode. And due to this lower turn on voltage for Schottky diode, normally we use Schottky diode in clamping circuits. So this is the first major difference between a Schottky diode and a PN diode, that is the reverse saturation current or reverse saturation current density for a Schottky diode is higher than the PN diode. And we can see that the mechanism for this reverse saturation current is different for Schottky diode and in PN diode. And the second major difference is the switching characteristic. Or switching speed. That is turning on and off or switching between forward bias and reverse bias. So the second major difference between a Schottky diode and a PN diode is in the frequency response. So if we apply a AC signal or if we want to use a diode in a higher frequency range or in a AC signal, then the response of the device or the divide diode should be in the range of the change of the frequency of the applied signal. So it's very important. And we know that the current in the Schottky diode is due to the injection of majority carriers or a potential barrier. As I said in earlier lecture, that normally we make a Schottky diode between a metal and a n-type semiconductor. So when we, let's say this is metal and this is a n-type semiconductor. So when we make it in forward bias, or when we apply a bias to this device, then since in metal there are majority of electrons, or electrons are in majority, and in n-type semiconductor the electrons are also in majority. So when there is a current in this device, so there is always an injection of the majority carriers. So this is very important phenomena in Schottky diode, because this Schottky diode is a, or the current in the Schottky diode is due to the injection of the majority carriers. But we saw in PN junction on PN diode, the current is due to the injection of the minority carriers. And by the energy band diagram, of a Schottky diode, we can see that there can be electrons in the metal directly near to the empty states in the semiconductor. So when we make a metal semiconductor junction, plenty of empty states near this junction in the metal side are available for the electrons if they want to move to the metal side, and vice versa. And these empty states are responsible for fast switching in Schottky diode. And we know that if an electron from the valence band wants to If an electron from the valence band of the semiconductor wants to flow into the metal, this effect would be equivalent to
होल और होल्स, बीइंग इंजेक्टेड इनटू द सेमीकंडक्टर, since one electron is going from the valence band, so there is a hole in the valence band. So if in a Schottky junction, if an electron directly goes from valence band to the metal side, it will create a hole in the valence band, or we can treat it as a hole. So this hole can also act as a minority carriers in n type semiconductor, but this amount of the holes is very less in Schottky diode. So this injection of holes would create excess minority carriers, that is holes in the N region or N side, whatever you want to say it. However, the ratio of the minority carriers holes current to the total current is extremely low. Since there are some minority carriers in Schottky diode also, but their contribution in the total current is very less or very low. So in this way we can say that the Schottky diode is a majority carrier device. This fact means that there is no diffusion capacitance associated with a forward biased Schottky diode. the elimination of the diffusion capacitance makes the Schottky diode a higher frequency device than the PN diode. And also when switching a Schottky diode from forward to reverse bias, there is no minority carrier stored charge to remove. As was the case in the PN diode. Since there is no minority carrier storage time the Schottky diode can be used in fast switching applications. A typical switching time for a Schottky diode is in the picosecond range. While for a PN diode, it is normally in the
nanosecond range. So in this way, we can see that the switching in the Schottky diode is faster than the switching in the PN diode, and it is due to the absence of minority carriers in Schottky diodes. As we saw that in forward bias, there is no diffusion capacitance associated with the Schottky diode. So switching in Schottky diode is easier than the PN diode. So in this way, we can see there are two major differences between a Schottky diode and a PN diode. Due to this differences, a Schottky diode can be used in a higher frequency electronic devices. And since the turn on voltage for Schottky diode is lower than the PN diode, we can easily use a Schottky diode in a clamping circuits. So this is all about the comparison between a Schottky diode and a PN diode.